press the bell icon on the YouTube app to never miss a video from News Laundry.
Has the Modi government really made Indian Railways safer? The Bharatiya Janata Party government has made three claims about safety measures in the Indian Railways on its 48-month portal. Claim 1. 2017-18 was the best ever year of the safety records for the Indian Railways. The claim also compares the number of accidents in 2013-14, the last year of the UPA term, to 2017-18, the fourth year of the Modi government. In 2013-14, there were 118 accidents, and in 2017-18, there were 73. Before we fact-check these claims, let's look at how accident is defined. The term accident refers to a wide spectrum of occurrences with or without significant impact on the system. Consequential train accidents include mishaps with serious repercussions in terms of loss of human life or injury, damage to railway property, or interruptions to rail traffic off the laid down threshold values or levels. These include collisions, derailments, fire or explosion in trains, road vehicles colliding with trains at level crossings, etc. Now, according to the data available on the Indian Railways website, there were 118 consequential train accidents in 2013-14. There were 73 such accidents in 2017-18. So the Modi government's first claim is accurate. But here's the catch. The infographic on the 48-month portal shows the data for 2013-14 and 2017-18. It doesn't mention that 135 consequential train accidents occurred in 2014-15, the first year of the Modi government. And this number is higher than the two numbers being quoted. What the infographic also skips is the fact that consequential train accidents have been on the decline since 2004, with 2014-15 being the only exception. Claim 2. 5,469 unmanned level crossings were eliminated, and the average pace of elimination is 20% more than what was eliminated during UPA 2, 2009 to 2014. As per answers given in Parliament, a total of 5,687 unmanned level crossings were eliminated during UPA 2, 2009 to 2014, an average of 1,137 per year. A total of 5,469 unmanned level crossings were eliminated during 2014 to 2018, an average of 1,367 per year. This roughly gives us a 20% rise. This makes the claim about the elimination rate of unmanned level crossings true. Claim 3. All unmanned level crossings on broad gauge routes were targeted to be eliminated by 2020. In December 2018, the government had stated that as on April 1, 2014, there were 8,948 UMLCs, that is unmanned level crossings on broad gauge. It also stated that all unmanned level crossings on broad gauge had been eliminated except 28. The government plans to eliminate these 28 by closure, merger, subway and manning. But the government's assertion is surprising. Since there were 3,479 unmanned level crossings on broad gauge as of April 1, 2018, of which only 28 are yet to be eliminated as of December 2018. This means that between April 2018 and December 2018, the government was able to eliminate more than double the number of unmanned level crossings that were eliminated in 2017-2018. Since the completion date is in 2020, we will have to wait to be able to verify this claim. So this claim remains unverified. This video has been produced in collaboration with Factly and IFCN.